Hey, what is up guys? This is Kira here from Uncle Kira the Future Productions on the EST2000 channel, and today we have a special video because Twitter has released a new dark mode. This is kind of a weird thing to make a video on, and I'm sorry for the lack of videos previously in the past month, but we should be having a new video every month, and this is kind of like a weird thing to talk about because usually I don't cover something that one app specifically did, but I have a bigger meaning to that, so stick around if you want to hear some stuff about iOS 10, and let's get to it. You go into Twitter, they just did something really massive, and something that no app has really done before, or a big app like this. You can turn on night mode now, and it just becomes all black and stuff. It looks really cool, and you love it, you know? Most people, I can't say everybody, but most people do love a dark mode. And so you're kind of thinking, well, you know, like, it's just weird to think about, you know? So here's the reason I'm making this video. If you go back and your eyes get adjusted to this, and then let's say you go into like any other iOS app, let's just say YouTube for this example, see how bright it is, and it just hurts your eyes, especially at night. That's a huge adjustment to go back to. So why hasn't iOS done this? Well, they say that iOS 10 is working on a dark mode, but it's beta 8 and they're still in a dark mode, so we probably won't see it until iOS 11. And this is something I really wanted to talk about. Is Apple really changing the game anymore? Used to, they would, you know, reinvent something significantly and then release developer APIs, and then in 2 weeks all the developers would have their apps accustomed to those changes. Now it seems to be the other way around. If you look at YouTube and Instagram, they already have this new soundbar. I know you guys can't see this because I'm recording, but if you know what I'm talking about, then drop a like on the video. They have a new soundbar, and it's something iOS 10 should have done, because let's face it, this old thing is just ugly, and it takes up half the screen and it blots what you're doing. Same with dark mode. If Twitter is releasing a dark mode and YouTube and Instagram have a new soundbar, then what's Apple doing? Is it become to the point where the developers are changing stuff in the app and then Apple copying that? I know Apple has copied a lot in Google and Windows sides before, but not really third-party developers like this. What's going on? Shouldn't there be an iOS 10 dark mode and then Twitter copy them to make it where their app is, you know, accustomed to iOS 10? I don't know. Let me know what you think down below. Is Apple kind of losing the game, and are third-party developers gaining more power to what they do? Let me know down below. Thank you guys. Oh, and okay, hold on. A problem is the YouTube and Instagram soundboard look completely different, but they still look both very good. So that's what happens when Apple doesn't make one unified software change. Then everything looks different, everyone has a different night mode, and it just gets kind of clustered after everyone does it, because everyone has a different take. Thanks for watching, let me know what you think down below, what your opinion is, and make sure you stay subscribed for new videos coming out really soon. A lot of good how to hack videos on Snapchat and Instagram and all those good stuff, so make sure you subscribe. Thanks for watching, and have a great day.